Welcome, friends of the Barrett family. Welcome to our family. I'm Luther Wiseman. I thought I was nervous 56 years ago in July. At that time, I became an agriculture and math teacher at Big Sandy School. I live closer to Big Sandy than I do to Canton, but my education was at Canton. The students at that time said, they found out I was from Canton, you'll be from Canton. I said, I hope I proved them wrong. And some of the former students are here today. I think this is a day that I'm going to reminisce, and I'm going to try to cover 56 years in 10 minutes. Don't ring the bell on me. Because there's so much that you former students, if you don't remember things like I said, exactly the way I tell them today, remember I'm 78 years old now. And you may be right and I may be wrong. But believe me, I believe our stories at the end will be very similar. These students were hard workers. And I can't talk about Bobby Barrett without talking about the Barrett family. Because look at these pictures. We look like, at that time, I just looked like one of them. I was only 5 years older than the seniors. At that time, Wayne Barrett was a senior. Danny Darty was a senior. Larry Waters was president of the chapter, he could say. They were on the soldier team, it took four, so little Bobby Barrett was on that sophomore. He made that team that year. Before I started teaching here, I was my last quarter in college, I did my student teaching. And that teacher was training a soil judging team. So I learned a little bit about soil judging. That year, we competed against that team. We won the district, we won the West Tennessee, went to the state contest. And that team that I was part of training the year before competed against us in the state. Guess what? These boys won the state. Therefore, I got to carry them to Oklahoma City for a week of international competition. Bobby was sophomore. There were three seniors. And I was a member of the seniors. So poor Bob, he was along with us. But he was not, and it was a little different. For Bobby. But Bobby's hung in there. And Bobby did. When we came back after a week, we came back at night. And Larry Waters liked to drive. So guess what? I rode in the front seat with Larry Waters and the other three students. Our water drove my car. I've been thinking, though, I'm going to ramble today, but that's okay. I've been thinking of a good name for Bob. And a good short name. I don't know how many of you know him well, but here's what I came up with. independent thinker. How many of you agree with that and knows it? Was he an independent thinker? My wife says that sounds like you, Luther. And might be. And those of you that know me, I may have been in. I'm not as independent a thinker as I was when I was teaching. Because, you know, things mellow with age. But, and I've mellowed. But these students, well, I mean, they kept me working. Every fall, these students, Big Sandy, would say, we had an FFA chapter. I haven't mentioned that. That's what I'm talking about. They started, we were going to practice this contest and that contest and so forth. The last, I taught 2 years, Big Sandy, they wanted me at Dyersburg, Tennessee. I didn't think they'd harm me because they told me what the salary was, and I jacked that up about $2,000 or $3,000. That's a lot of money back in 1964. They paid it. I didn't have any choice but to go. I didn't enjoy it because I'm away from home, and I'm homegrown. And I'm still at home. I'm living right across the road, thank God, from where I was born. Only time I've been away from there is when I was in school. So, some of you may remember Jack Cagle. He was on the school board at that time. And thanks to him, I got to come back after 1 year to Big Sandy. That's about unheard of, people. While Bobby was a sophomore and a junior, his senior year I was gone to Dyersburg. But I knew that he had an interest in forestry. Would you believe this little Bobby Barron took off to UT Knox, about the closest place then you could get a degree in forestry. He went to UT Knox, got a degree in forestry, came back home, and he volunteered and came to talk to some of my classes about forestry. My seniors liked it so well, Bobby volunteered, no pay, and the pay was not discussed. He volunteered and said, I'll teach night class to your seniors. They wanted to come. Can you believe that? One night a week for 3 hours. And he taught that class. I was there at each session. Gave him a half a credit in high school credits for boys. So Big Jack went with me to vocational. He had me. They took me in. They looked after Luke White. I need him. He had me to come down on Saturday mornings before daylight. Almost got hit by a train. The train used to come through here. Y'all don't remember that. But I almost got hit one here and Big Sandy one morning. Lemoyne, Jack's wife, the backbone, she fixed breakfast for us, and guess what? Big Jack would carry me down Lake Creek, crappie fishing, taught me how to catch crappie down at Lake Creek. Hey, these people are not members of Luke Wise's family. I'm sitting here today as the biggest hypocrite that you people have ever talked with. Okay, then, after we moved on, and Bobby was, he did survey work. I don't know when he got his survey. He did appraisal on timber and so forth for bids. Some of my close friends have bid on some tracks that he did timber on. I've talked to them, they have nothing but good words to say about Bob. And then some of the people, some of you, I didn't have an agriculture, but I had your math, and Linda's one of them over here. And you know, Linda's been, I got dealing with her more each year because she was processing deer, and then she went in taxidermy. And my grandson, I have one grandson, John, that little boy. The first trip, he deer hunting, he harvested deer, and he called my house, "Come on down there, Granddaddy, I've got one." Went down, loaded in the truck, carried down to Linda, and I asked Linda if it'd be possible to get that deer mounted before Christmas. The day before, she didn't do any deer heads. She was busy in deer processing the last Christmas. The day before Christmas, she called, and the deer head was ready. Okay? Then I have two granddaughters, and they've shown an interest in what's going to be a veterinarian. She's in ninth grade this year. And they showed an interest in hunting. Both of them in the last few years, both of them have harvested their first turkey and their first deer with me. Okay, Linda has done the heads on the deer, and she took some wood from her farm, old wood, and put it in those, mound them, made them perfect for those girls. Friends like this, you don't find, like the Barretts, you don't find those kind of people. Not in my opinion. And that's a generation. Hopefully you younger ones will carry on the family tradition. Because these are the grassroots of our nation. And if we can't realize that, we're all in a bad vacuum. And I was thinking this morning, I can't talk about, without talking about the FFA, because these students built this school. The last 5 years of teaching at Pickett, that's the only teaching I ever did, except that 1 year of Dyesburg. The last 5 years of Big Sandy, the state, the West Tennessee has a banquet in Memphis each year with all FFA activities and passes out awards. The last 5 years that I've taught, Big Sandy got the cup for number one. 1 year, the cup for number two, 2 years, and the cup for number three for 2 years. The last 5 years, this was cool. With these working kids, was in the top three in West Tennessee at all activities. Don't you think that this old man has a lot to be proud of? And I'm telling you, I am thankful, and I am proud. And I saw Terry Hudson back here a while ago, and I said, "Terry, I thought of you this morning. You know what I remember about you?" And he quoted it to me back then. You should have seen that little boy. He won the West Tennessee FFA Creed, "I believe in the future of farming, with a faith born not of words but of deeds. Achievements won by the present and past generation of farmers." Didn't know all the creed. he went to the state at Chattanooga, and there were 1,500 people out in the audience. And you should have seen that little boy get up like I am now behind the podium and say the FFA for me. That don't make your heart quiver. You don't have to. And now, I'm going to move on and let you know that Bob, call it Bob, that he was more to me than just a student. The last time that I saw Bob in person, I looked it up, was last September. I called, I was selling a piece of land I had, and the guy was going to build on it. And I called, and little Jack, I called you little Jack, because I'm going, but, and little Jack answered. He said, I don't know, I'll have to talk to Dad. I'll call you back. That was either Monday or Tuesday. He called me back, and he said, we could either be there Friday morning or Monday morning. And you could have anything to do with having surveys done. Am I a coach friend? Am I a family member? Do I have to tell you more? And I'm thankful. I'm not bragging. I'm thankful that I have friends like that. And I said, oh, Monday will be fine. And let me tell you the rest of the story. On Monday morning, they were going to be there somewhere around 8 o'clock, so I went over. They were already there. And the guy behind the property was there. He and I are close friends, and he flies the Ironback plane. Some of you may have had dealings with him. Dan Abbott. And I've fallen in love with his family. Anyway, he told me, little Jack does more work. He told me, he said, I told him they got here prepared for this job. And little Jack told him something to this effect. When Mr. Weisner is concerned, my dad makes time. Isn't that great? Isn't that to be thankful?
Amen.
Okay. And I am, if I had 5 minutes here. Anyway, I figured my wife is down one. Anyway, I told her I was going to try to do this for 6 years, and I said in 10 minutes, she said, I thought 15. Anyway, I just wanted to, last Tuesday morning, I think it was, Brittany, she's here somewhere, she called me, and I'd already found out, I think Jamie had texted my son the night before, and my son texted my wife, and here she comes over to me, puts her arm on me, and tells me. At that time, she said, I'm going to be off the rest of the week. We didn't discuss why or anything. We have discussed why, because I knew why she was taking off the rest of the week. She knew I hurt. And I prayed hard, people, that I could get up here and talk with you today without breaking that. And so far, so. Anyway, I told Brittany, I said, let's just pray that I'll be able to go to the school. And then the next day, or maybe the same day, my son texted my wife and said, thank you, Jamie. He said, hey, thank you, Sam. And people have had to do this very thing lots of times in the last few years. My Lord said he would not put more on Luther than Luther could bear.
Right.
And I had that red flag thing. And so when the survey was ready, Bob wanted to deliver the survey himself. He came and brought it, and we talked a lot that last September. But I'll back up one other thing before I quit. And little Jack, you'll remember this. A few years ago, I don't remember what year, y'all came driving up my driveway, and I was outside, and I didn't know who it was. And it got out, and it was Bob and little Jack. And here I am. We don't know what God has in plan. And if you don't know my God, you know how I know God? I still sin constantly, probably committed some while I've been up here. But God convicts Luther Wiseman, convicts me, and I ask for forgiveness, and we go from there. Okay? I don't know how he does you, I know you sin. Only one that didn't sin, there won't be another. So I want to leave with you. My wife is of a letter. She and I have been married 11 years. Most of you know some of the history on the other. 11 of the other, I know. Anyway, my wife has done things that we really like, and I really like, for people during these 11 years. And I asked her to do something for you four children of Bob, kind of have a little remembrance, and also for Linda. And I have not covered, you know, I looked out of this. I don't know what's on here that I may have left out. Lots. But I believe I've had my 15 minutes. I didn't even look. It took my minute being 2:30. I didn't get started over 2 o'clock. Anyway, this is supposed to be a time that we have joy.
Amen.
We're supposed to have joy. And I've had Bible scholars, I've had college professors, I've had, I don't know how many people researching something that I'd always been taught. And my wife thought it was in the Bible. She knows the Bible. I'd always been taught that we humans have got it backwards, that we should have joy at death and mourn at birth.
That's right.
But people, if you know where it is, if you can find it like that, I want to see it.
Okay.
But I believe it. I believe it. Okay? Now, Dorothy, I would like to leave you with a little memento to remember your dad by and remember your brother by. I'm 70, this is the first time I've ever been asked to say something at this occasion. So if I didn't take something, I can't. And hopefully I haven't bored you to death. Hopefully that I've... And Danny Hudson's in here somewhere. He was. And another little tale on that. These students like to hunt with me because they had fun. And a few years ago, we were hunting down Sand River, and we walked across the river to shoot some wood ducks late across the river. And it got dark, I didn't have a flashlight, and I couldn't see it. I didn't know where it was. And I went to yelling for them, where's the river? Where's the river? And Dan has used that ever since. Where's the river? So we've got little things that people that, I didn't know where the river was, but they yelled back at me, and I found the river. I shouldn't use the word I've enjoyed it, but this has been an occasion that Luther Wiseman will not forget. And hopefully you don't forget. And remember, you may already know it, but if you don't know it, Jesus loves you. And he's got open arms. He's just waiting for you. It's so easy if you'll just ask. You'll receive if you'll ask with your heart. Okay? So, people, it's not possible for Luther Wiseman to get up any place. And I don't do it intentionally. My wife says, I'll be in a crowd and won't know anyone. In a few minutes, I'm talking about God. Because God, without God, what's happened in Luther Wiseman's life in the last few years, I would not be here. And believe you me. All right? Anything else? Thank y'all for asking me. I am a member of their family.
Sure are, Luther. Thank you so much. We love you.
I love all of them. If you don't believe that, give me a chance.
Amen.
I did look up this is the 1965 annual, the first annual when I became a teacher. I looked it up to verify a lot of my things I remember. Okay. If you don't have one of these, you need to look at it for one sometime. There stood that little Bobby Bear, that sophomore in here. Okay.
Thank you.
I talk like you people are little to me, but hopefully you understand.
Amen. We do.
Thank y'all.
Born a young poor country boy, Mother Nature's son. All day long I'm sitting singing songs for everyone. Sit beside a mountain stream, see your waters flow. Pretty sound of music as she flies. Do 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 do. Mother Nature's son, swaying daisies, sing a lazy song beneath the sun. Yeah. just supposed to sing, but I just had to clear my throat.
Yep.
And I think if anybody knows my Uncle Bob, that's exactly how he could. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you're only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sucking eyes and learn to see. All your life, you are only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird fly, blackbird fly, into the light of the dark black
was devoted to many things. His education, the business that he built, the small town that he loved and supported throughout his life, and to the people of Big Sandy too. He loved horses from a young age, and for years he raised cattle. He was an avid hunter. He enjoyed traveling and he loved history. But he was devoted to his family most of all, and to the memory of his father, which was never far from his mind. In many ways, it was the memory of his father, Jack Barrett, or from now on, Big Jack, that formed his worldview more than anything. The Barretts had escaped the Dust Bowl in Oklahoma, and Jack had fought bravely in the United States Army's 7th Infantry Division, where he was gravely wounded on the island of Leyte in the Pacific Theater. He survived and made his way to Big Sandy, Tennessee, to marry Mabel Lemoyne Bradley, and they started a family. They were poor, and they worked very hard, and they were happy. He loved the forest of Tennessee. It was his profession and his passion. He counted himself lucky to be able to study trees for a living. Recently, he wrote about a group of ancient American beech trees on his farm, and he said, "It is hard for me to think that I should own these trees. Rather, that for a while, a short while along their schedule, I am just pleased to have merely been their steward." And as all good foresters do, he thought about the future of those forests and the people who would watch over them. He wrote, "There are many points of kindred interest all over this place that I wish my grandchildren will love as I do. And if they will love it, I want them to learn to be stewards too." Our father designed his driveway to wind through our family farm, past his two ponds, and past the stand of pine that he planted with his brother in the 1960s. Then, through a great stand of oaks that he nurtured for decades and onto his house. As you approach the top of the ridge, the driveway passes narrowly between two beautiful white oaks. In his later years, he jokingly referred to these as the pearly gates. He would say, "I had just passed through the pearly gates when I saw my driveway does with this year's crop of fawns." He loved that trip along his driveway every day, and it gives us peace to know that he passed through the pearly gates one last time.
Father, as we come to a close today, Lord, we want to thank you so much for the opportunity to celebrate the life of this wonderful man here today. Lord, not all words could be said. Not all of his legacy could be told today because there's too many years and it's been too long, Lord. But Father, we thank you so much for giving each and every one of us in here a peace, a place, some wisdom, some knowledge, and something to hang on to that he left behind for each and every one of us. We thank you so much, Lord, that he come across our paths, not just family, but across many people's paths, for they have explained that to me, that he was a very, very important person in their life, and they respected him highly. Lord, thank you so much for sharing the intelligence that you gave him with us. Thank you so much for giving us the determination that you gave him. And thank you so much, Lord, for letting us be a big part of his life. And as we bid him farewell today, Lord, only in flesh, we will know by the Spirit, each and every one of us, we will feel him every day. We'll feel his touch, his love, his memories, and everywhere we look in this little town and on that farm down there, we will be reminded of the many, many things he taught each and every one of us. For that, we thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.